everyone. I'm Brooke from Classtime's team, and today I'm going to walk you through how to get started with Classtime in under 10 minutes. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate for you how to sign up for Classtime, find content, set up your classes, start your first session, adjust your session settings, and finally export your session results. So to sign up for Classtime, we will head to classtime.com and click Teacher Sign Up. Here you'll have the option to authenticate with your Google, Microsoft, Clever, or Facebook account. This is a great option if you don't want to have to memorize a password, but you also have the option to sign up with your email and password as well. I also want to note that everything I am demonstrating today is going to be on a school license account. If you're all signed up for Classtime, you'll be in your questions tab. So this is where all of the content that I add is going to live. If you are on a school or district license, there might be content already preloaded and ready for you to use in your My Questions tab. For example, I already have the strategic thinking and math content here. But to find content, you're going to click on the search bar and search a grade and subject that is relevant for your class. So I'm going to type in sixth grade reading. So go ahead and scroll through and see what looks best for me. And here I'll be able to preview each question individually, see if this is something that would work for my students. I'll also be able to see what standards this question set addresses and hover over the tag icon on each individual question to see what standard this question aligns with. Once I feel like this question set is good for my class, I'm going to add it to my questions. Now that I've added that question set to my questions, I can edit it and make it my own. So I'm going to scroll down here and find that question set I just added, this one. And here I'm going to be able to select individual questions that maybe I want to remove from the question set entirely, or I can go into each question, edit it. Maybe I want to add a YouTube video, add audio, change the image. I also have the option to change the question type entirely. Maybe I want to change this from a multiple choice question to a checkbox question. I can easily do that. I also have the option to add my own new questions. So to do that, I'll click New Question and select from our various different question types and add some of my own content. So now that I have prepped this question set and made it my own, it's time to set up my classes. Classes was a feature that was designed to help teachers to better organize their students and have more control over who is joining their sessions. So you can create a class manually by clicking Create Class here, and you'll just enter a class name and subject. And click Create. Now I see this class here and I will be able to manually invite my students using their individual emails by clicking Invite Students. And I can either add previously verified students or just type in the student's email here. Another great part of classes is the ability to import from Google Classroom. So you will be able to directly import your classes into Classtime with just a few clicks, and you only have to set up that integration one time. You'll just have to authorize and allow Classtime to have access once. And now that I've done that, I can see that this class, for example, has been imported from Google Classroom because I see the little logo in the bottom right-hand corner here. Another great feature of classes is co-teachers. So if you are on the school license, you're going to be able to add as many co-teachers as you want to your class, and your co-teachers are going to be able to invite your students to a session as well and view all of that session data. So this is a really helpful feature for substitutes or teacher assistants to be able to step in for a day and pick up right where you left off. I can add my co-teachers by clicking Add Co-teachers here and inviting them from a school like this. Okay, so now you've found your content, you've set up your classes, and it's time to start your first session. So in order to do that, we're going to navigate back to My Questions. I'm going to find that question set that I want to use once more. Here it is. And then I'm going to click the blue Start Session button. Now I'm directed to my session settings, and here I have so many options to tailor this session to my teaching preferences. So say I want to shuffle my question answer options to discourage cheating or show solutions immediately if I'm using this session less as an assessment but more for self-practice. I also have the ability to offer my students partial points with or without penalty for partially correct answers. I can also enable round-based mode, which shows each question step-by-step in a fixed order, or schedule my session if I only want to make it available, say, Tuesday afternoon as a homework assignment. I'll click Session Scheduler and set that time period here. Now I'll move along to our personalizable settings. These settings can be adjusted per individual student. These settings include our timer, which can be enabled here and then adjusted per student on the dashboard, and then the teacher-student live chat, where you can chat one-on-one with a student during a session, and then our read-aloud setting, which will allow a student to listen to question descriptions, titles, answer options. This can also be tweaked per individual student as well. Then if you'd like to gamify your session and encourage your students to work together, you can enable the collaborative challenges. Your collaborative challenge is meant to be projected on a wall and screen shared for all students to track their collective progress while answering the questions on their own devices. And so as more questions are answered correctly, they're going to be able to make progress on the challenge, for example, building a roller coaster or saving an endangered species. If you'd like to really lock down your session, you can use our safe exam browser integration, which is going to turn any device into a temporarily secure workstation. So it's going to really control access to other websites and apps and prevent your students from accessing unauthorized resources during an exam. So once I have selected my settings, I can either click proceed or I can invite my class directly from here. I'm going to click proceed. And here I'm going to be able to either share my session code with my students and they can join that way, or I can copy this link. I still have the option to also invite my class. You have a couple of options when it comes to your students joining your session. So you can either share the session code and they can type it in on classtime.com. You can also just share the session link directly with them. Or if they're accessing through Google Classroom or our Microsoft Teams integration, they do not need to know a code. They'll just click on the invite in that new assignment in Google Classroom or Microsoft Teams. I'm going to go ahead and join my own session using my session code. So I'll just type it in here and click join. And then here I have the option to either type in a nickname or authenticate with my Google Microsoft Clever account. I'm going to go ahead and join with a nickname. Here we can see what a session looks like from the student's point of view. This is one of our checkbox questions, and I also have the read aloud feature enabled. This allows the student to listen to the question and also the answer options by clicking on the read aloud button here.
Summer is the best time to watch animals.
And once they've completed all of the questions, they will hand in their assignment. Flipping back to the teacher view, I want to share a couple of extra session tips. I can always change my session settings, even if a session has already started. If I want to do that, I'll just click on my session settings here and I can adjust them. So I have full freedom and there's really no mistakes that I can make when setting up my session before it begins. I might want to hide my students' names, and I can do that by clicking sorted by name, clicking hide names, or I can also sort by performance or sort by progress. I also have the freedom to toggle off individual questions if I want all of my students to just work on question number 3 first. I can do that by toggling off question number 1, 2, 4. I can also pause my session, which will lock all of my students' screens, or ending my session will prevent all of my students from being able to join the session and answer questions. So finally, it's time to export your session results. You can do that directly in the session itself, or you can head over to your sessions tab where you can view all of your current and past sessions. Here, you'll notice that my open sessions have a blue circle and my closed sessions have a gray circle. And you'll also notice that I have so many sessions open, so I can be running multiple sessions at the same time. This is really helpful for differentiation or when you have many different classes. I can go ahead and export my session results by clicking download, and I can download as an Excel or PDF by session or by student. That is it, guys. I really hope that this video helped you to kickstart your journey with Classtime. If you have not yet signed up, you can do so using the link in our description box below. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys next time.